Hey guys, Chris from Harmony Turbines here, and we are finally up to the episode where we're going to release, for the first time ever, drumroll, we're going to actually release data. Raw data that we took on October 14th, the really, really windy day. If you're up in the Northeast, you know that we had a really windy day on the 14th. We went outside and recorded actual data on the turbine that was in the back of the truck. So I need to preface this with a few things, okay? If you sit there in the comments and you write, well, you did this or you did that, and there's something that I'm about to say right now, then you didn't watch the video, you didn't listen, okay? So I'm gonna say it right now. There's a bunch of things that we obviously know we need to improve on and that will be improved upon going forward. So think of this as like the bar is finally set. It's not gonna get any worse than this. It can only go up from here. As we keep making incremental improvements, we're going to get better and better and better. So that's number one. The data right now isn't fantastic. It's not amazing, but you can't sit there and say, oh, well, Harmony's a waste of time because the data's only showing this. Well, heck, there's thousands of other things that have been developed over the last 200 years that always start down at the bottom. You build from that base. So this is where we are. We're starting with this data. It's the first release of our public data that we're sharing of performance we got in real wind conditions on October 14th. Now, the wind that day was gusty. It was gusty as hell. It was all over the place. It would gust and then it would stop, and then it would gust and it would stop. So it wasn't amazing data, but it was some data. And we finally have the data capturing capability to log that for you. So you're gonna see the truck shaking. Yes, the truck has shocks and it's got springs and it moves back and forth. The turbine's in the back of it sticking 8 feet up in the air. Of course, it's going to be rocking. That doesn't mean we had hurricane force winds. There were a few times, and I mean like, I don't know, maybe 8 or 10 times in the videos where we actually got up above 10 meter per second winds. So that's equivalent to about a 20 mile an hour wind. It's like one half. When you're at a 12 meter per second wind, you're somewhere around 25 miles per hour wind. So we're going to be giving numbers in meters per second, not miles per hour, because this is how we do all our calculations. Meters per second. Sorry, I know I live in America, but yeah, to make this easier, we're doing meters per second. It helps us to standardize. And you have to remember that the data is going to get better and better and better as we keep improving things, as we keep finding better generators, better geometries for our scoops, things like that. Just a few other things to remind you of before we get started. The wind in the back of the truck is swirling because the truck is like a great big bowl. It's the back of a pickup truck. So as soon as the wind goes in, it swirls and everything like that. So even though we were trying to be broadside to the wind, it's still, the truck is blocking wind. It's messing up the wind. So it's not like having the turbine out there in your yard, 10 feet off the ground in nice, you know, wind that nothing's obstructing it. So the truck is blocking a good majority of the wind and screwing things up in and of itself. Another thing to keep in mind, we do not yet have a torque sensor on the turbine in this footage. We're actually doing that right this moment. The guys are hooking up our torque sensor to the back of the unit. We're going to be going out and doing some video of that in the truck, but today is a totally dead day. So that'll be driving data and not what we want. So this footage was taken on the 14th of October. We didn't have a torque sensor on it, so we can't corroborate the wattage that the generator was producing with the actual torque that the generator was being subjected to. And now that we have this sensor on here, we'll actually be able to get two independent numbers of what our output should be. So one of the readings is going to be very much like a dynamometer reading or an eddy current break, where we get the torque value and then multiply that by the RPMs, we can come up with wattage. The other is the raw wattage that's coming out of the generator. We know this part, the generator, is like anyone's guess right now. We're trying a whole bunch of different ones because we're trying to find one that produces well for us in the RPM range that we need. So this is all we have right now, just the data coming out of the generator. It's not the greatest test of what our turbine is doing, because now that we have this torque sensor on here, we'll be able to see how closely these two are in conjunction with one another. I think it's going to be more like this. The generator is going to say we're producing, let's say, 200 watts of power in a certain amount of wind, and the torque sensor says, no, you're really producing this. the discrepancy would simply be because the generator isn't able to pick up all of that power. It's in the wrong RPM range or whatever. Imagine it like this. If I had a little tiny handheld generator right now and I was spinning it, and this little generator was something that was tuned to spin at 1,000 RPM, well, I can't spin at 1,000 RPM. So I'm never going to be able to make the maximum that that little generator can produce, no matter how hard I try, because I physically can't go that fast. Likewise, if I would get a great big generator that was, a 2-horsepower generator, and I was sitting there trying to crank it by hand, I also couldn't run that one to the right amount because I wouldn't be able to go fast enough. So you have to have the generator tuned correctly for the turbine. The two have to be very close together. This torque sensor that we're now putting on the turbine right now as we speak, they're over there connecting it, that is an independent number that should really, really closely approximate what the turbine itself is producing. So that's why we're doing it. That's why we're putting the torque sensor on the unit, because as we're testing the torque, we can also see what the generator is putting out. And these two, my theory is they're going to be like this. The torque sensor is going to be saying we're producing more than the generator is. We'll share that data as we get it. So this is the fun part. And this is where I said all along, we're not going to hide. We're not going to shy away and not show you the pieces of data that might not be as good as we'd like them to be. We're going to share it with you all. You just have to do your part and understand that this is early data. It's raw, unedited data, and it's going to be getting better from here. So we're kind of at the ground level, and everything is going to keep improving as we improve our system, as we tweak the system, as we find better and better ways to gather that power from the turbine and then move it and turn it into electrical output. So here we go. Gusting wind is really, really challenging. We're broadside to the wind right now as best we can be. If the wind would just 89, 90, 100 to 120, under 5. Yeah, dude. I keep seeing over 100. Yep, 115.
Holy crap, how many meters per second's that?
Our coefficient of power is like, it's hard to say. But I think we're somewhere in the 16% efficiency range when it's so hard to catch it. Yeah. We'll be able to parse the data and see it a little bit better, but it'll be a scatter plot, that's for sure. Okay. Oh, 8 meters per second wind. We got up over 100 watts. Brian, I'd be curious to try 16 watts.
Ohms.
Or 16 ohms, yeah, sorry. Oh. I don't want to get excited or anything, but that seems to be... some exciting numbers. Oh. 9 meters per second, 142, 146. Dude, we almost made 200 watts right there for a blip. Yep. Did you see that too?
Yeah, I saw that on the load.
Yeah, okay. The load cell confirmed it?
Yeah. About
120 yeah.
Right now.
That's exciting. So the best we saw there was maybe getting up into the, just barely breaking into the 200 watt range. That's not ideal. It's not what I want to see, but remember, we're starting here at the ground level. We have nowhere to go but up as we keep improving things, finding better gear ratios, finding better electrical resistance, finding better generators with the unit. As we get our torque sensor on the bottom and can start looking at how everything's correlating, all these things are going to help us improve our data and improve our efficiency of the overall system. So right now, you know, obviously if you're sitting there like, oh, this is a waste of time, they're only making 200 watts in a 25 mile an hour wind. Remember, that was a blip of 25 mile an hour wind. It wasn't sustained. So you also have to remember, we've got a lot of things going on there with the swirling winds in the truck. The truck itself is blocking a certain amount of wind. There's a lot of things that play into this. So just because we were sitting still does not mean that's how well it would produce out in the plains or out on the coast in a true 25 mile an hour wind. And I almost forgot, for those of you who are data miners and diehard, you know, I want the data, I want to see the raw footage, the whole unedited footage, we'll tell us. If you really want to see that, we'll put it together. It's probably going to be 2 or 3 hours worth of strung together videos where you can just watch the whole big, huge, boring set of data. But if that's your thing and you want that, email us or, you know, send us feedback on the YouTube videos saying you'd like to see that whole big, huge chunk of videos, and we'll string them together and put them out there for you. I myself have already sat there and watched through them all, and I can tell you they're pretty boring. You're just staring at numbers for the most part. But what we can do is call out some of the good spots in those videos where the wind finally does kick up for a moment, and then you can see them. So let us know if that's something you'd be interested in, and we will share that as well. So thank you to all of our followers, all of our supporters, our investors, everyone who has been with us on this journey from the beginning. Thank you. We're here because of you. We're here for you. We're doing all of this to try and, in the end, make the world a better place. And that means giving you the data, giving you the results as we go through this project. We're telling the story and sharing it with you as we go along. So thank you for being here, for helping us to get where we are. Our subscribers, our followers, our YouTube subscribers, everyone in the community, our investors, you make Harmony Turbines great. And we're here because of you. So thank you for all of that. Thank you for just being along with our journey and making us what we are today. Chris from Harmony Turbines, thank you guys. Take care. Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.